Hey, Roy Marsh here again with Team Voice Gracie's Southern Pines, and again I'm here with Daniel Young. This is a part two of a video I'm doing for a friend at Pantera MMA in Osnabrück, Germany. He asked about takedowns from the street where I don't want to put my knees on the ground, and I certainly don't want to pull guard. So again, I want to emphasize that these are not intended for MMA or sport. They'll absolutely work for that, but that's not my consideration. My consideration is, how do I do a takedown that stops me from having to drag my knees on the ground or fall to the ground with him or pull guard? So I want my takedowns to keep me standing, take him down with me having the option to go down or stay standing. Last time we worked the double leg, we worked it off of him punching. We're gonna work a single leg. And this is done differently than a wrestling single leg, and I'll talk a little bit different about it. There's absolutely nothing wrong with wrestling single leg, it's fantastic. It's just a little bit different and a little easier for me to do this one. So we'll talk about this a little bit. First thing that's going to be a little bit different is my entry. So normally we enter a lot of the shots with our lead leg. This one I'm actually going to enter with my outside leg. Okay? So it's going to enter off my two punch. It's not going to enter off my single, my one. So when we come in, I'm going to throw my one. When I throw my two, I'm going to step here. Okay, so we're here. This is either one, two. I'm not going to throw my two with my back leg, retract, and then try to step. It's going to follow my punch.
Bang,
bang, here. So as it comes through, it's going to drop down. And here's the difference. I'm not going down with my shoulder into his hip and trying to pick the leg up and do the global, staying low on the hip. For a couple reasons. This encourages him to keep good posture here. Okay, he can maybe sprawl his hips back and be strong here. Okay, as well as I'm a little bit more susceptible to guillotines and front headlocks that I gotta then find out. Okay, so what I want to do is, by keeping my back straight and in his chest, when I bump him back, this leg becomes light. Okay. So I'm not trying to come in here, pick the leg up. I'm using my body, keeping my back straight, listening to his ear, which makes it harder for him to push my head away. If my head's up here and guillotine me, yeah, he can't. And by driving forward, this leg becomes light for me to pick up because it's pushing his upper body back. Okay? The other thing I'm not gonna do is try to grab around the knee like this. This encourages him to put his foot on the outside of my hip. Here, and then I have trouble doing the takedown. I actually want to keep my hands as fairly straight as possible and look for the calf if I can get it. So when I come in, bang, bang, my hands are down here, not like this. Because I'm trying to keep his leg straight. My back is straight, my head is up, and I'm going to walk forward and pass the leg between. Again, I'm like this, not like this. I'm only going to hang out here for a second. I just wanted to show you guys that. Okay, not here. Here, so I pick his leg up straight, rather than pick his leg up at the knee, here, okay? So a lot of things happen there. So again, I come one, two, here, outside leg. Also makes it, if he does sprawl on me here, boom, see, I can already move to the back, because I'm a little bit off to the side. Okay. One, two, here. I'm gonna, again, down the calf, I drive forward. Here, as soon as I get him moving, now I'm stopping, but in reality I'm going to keep moving the whole time. As soon as I get his leg up, this hand goes to the hip. Okay. I'm going to step back with my right leg, pull the hip, and bring him down. Okay. One reason, again, I like this is kind of like the last time. With the traditional single leg, boom, here, and I run the fight. Last time he ends up right in front of me. Okay, and I'm dealing with maybe him kicking away or playing guard or all of this stuff. By pulling the hip, it puts him on his side a little. Okay? So let's do the other side. Okay? So we're here, I throw a boom. Boom.
Here, drive, hip, and I'm pulling, sending back.
Here, he does this. Now, if I wanted to, we're in a fight or we're in a grappling situation. My back knee, cut through, work, Yeah, now we're going to focus on that top-down situation we're working on right here, okay? When I do this move, I want to move forward and then immediately turn. I'm not going to stop at any point. I'm not going to come in, boom, boom. I'm trying to pick his leg up, okay? It's forward and then immediately cut back. So I go one, two, boom, immediately cut back. Right here, okay? Or I can exhale. So again, I want to emphasize, this is not our traditional, you know, shoot here kind of takedown. I'm not putting my knees on the ground. I like my knees. So for my friends over in Osnabrück or anywhere else, nice basic single leg for a little bit more of a street situation.